Okay, now we are going to look at how do we create mass rate tables. How many types of mass data do we have, boss? Okay, let's say, can Kiver have its own mass data tables? No, only characteristic. Every characteristic in FOBIT can have its own attribute table, text table, hierarchy table. Point is clear. So there will be three types: attributes, text, and then hierarchy, suppose. Okay. Now what I'm trying to show is what kind of information do you store in attributes? Attribute table. So attribute is one master data table, text is one separate table, hierarchy is one separate table. So what kind of data do you store in attributes? Say, let's say we are building metal master. Okay. So what kind of information do you store in metal attribute table? All the properties which provides more meaning towards the metal number. All the attributes or properties which provides more meaning towards metal number. Now what do you meet in the text table? Descriptions of multiple languages. You know understand the importance of text table now. Then in hierarchies, what do you maintain? All the parent-child data. When you want to have this level up, level down effect in the hierarchies, in the reporting, you go with hierarchies. Yeah. Let's see. Now I'm trying to, let's say we want to model a metal master bus. So how will I use those infobics and create the master is what we're trying to focus now. Okay, look at this. I want a master like this. Metal number, okay. Metal type I want, metal group I want, yeah. Metal price I want, and the currency of the price. Metal type, metal price, currency. I want the created date. When is this metal created? When was this metal newly created? I want the date. So this is what the master I want to do. And where this will be my, the main key. Created date for the metal bus, metal master. So whenever they introduce new metal, they create the metal master, right? So I want the date when this metal record was created. Record. This is what I wanted to do. So now all these are infobics, but metal type, group, price, currency, and then created date are what? Attributes of what? Metal. That is what I wanted to model. So how many infobics will I have to create if I need to build this structure? Six objects. Okay, now let's model this out. So I'll go to infobics menu. Get into characteristic catalog, right click, say what? First let me create, for each column let me create infobics, then I'll group them to create master database. Okay. What is the first column? Was metal number. ZMMNO. Okay, I'll say material number. See, for now there is no business or no customer who is giving me requirements. I am just practicing myself. So there is no hard and fast rule that I should take namsina care and emla na ishtam iskuntanu naaku manasuki edan pichcha iskuntanu. Okay, but generally if you want to go with something, let's say I want to have values like m-101 in this. So what is the kind of data type will you go with? Care, and length is what? 5. That's it. Okay, as it is now, I don't want attribute table, I don't want text table. So I just want activate, I just want the characteristic first of all, yeah. Then what I want, metal type, yeah. ZMM type, yeah. I would say metal, type, yeah. So again, I'll say type would be something like stationery, yeah, sports, or which type of products. I will go with something like length 12. For this, I don't want attribute table, I don't want text table. When I activate, will it create SI table? For every characteristic, SID is must, okay. Then I want metal, metal group I want, yeah. ZMMGRP, yeah. Material group. Again, I want to say something care and say something, say I want to go with 12, yeah. Okay, let's say now, for metal group, I want to go with numc. Now, because I'm going to have it like this. Metal group is going to hold like, say 10. Or 20 or 30. I'll have a different meaning what 10 and 20 or 30 mean. But for me, the metal column will have 10, 20 and 30. That's it. Okay. So I'm going with numc, and what will be length? 2. As it is, I don't want attribute or I don't want text for me. Activate. Metal type is done. What is the next column? Price. What type of infobit is this? price, key figure, yeah. Good. I'll go to keyword catalog, create info object, say ZMMPRC. Price, okay. What is it? No. Amount. And do you see here, I've got referencing of the currency price. So do I have a separate column now? Amount and referencing to what? I can use zero currency. I don't have to create anything new. Yeah. Then what next is what? So if zero currency is taken care by this column, what is the next column? Was? Created date. So can I go with zero calde for this? Date field, I can go with zero calde. Yeah. Good. So I need to create zero calde or no? It's already there. I just can use it now. Now, once all my info objects are ready, now I need to use info objects like metal type, group, price, currency, and then date as what? Attributes of what? Metal number, and build the attribute table of metal number. Now I need to, all the objects are ready. Can metal number have attribute table? Can metal number have text table? Can metal number have hierarchy table? Yes. Can metal type have attribute table? Can metal type have text table? Can metal type have hierarchy table? Metal group have attribute table? Metal group can have text table? Can metal group have hierarchy? Yes. Every characteristic can have its own attribute table, text table, hierarchy table, depending on the requirement. For me, as per my business requirement, when I am doing reporting, my business is expecting to see more properties of the metal number. That's why I plan to maintain attributes for metal number. So I would like to build attribute table for what? Metal number by using these columns, these info objects here. So how do I do this? Select the metal number, right click, I'll go to what now? Say change. Where do you indicate the system that I want attribute table for this? Where do you indicate? Master text tab. By enabling this checkbox, you indicate I want attribute table for metal number. As soon as I say I want, then what does it ask you? Then tell me attributes, what attributes you want. When I say I want attribute table for metal number, tell me what info objects do you want as attributes. ZMM type, which I already created, then what? ZMM GRP group, then what? ZMPRC price, sorry, no. ZMMPRC. So when I use price, it automatically brings what? Zero currency. Then what is the other one? Zero calde we wanted. That's it. Now, so I am creating attribute table of metal number by using all these five objects as attributes. Okay. Now, when I activate, internally, now it creates the attribute table for us. And this is where you can see the name of the attribute table. Okay. And now you create attribute table for which info bit bus? Metal number, right? What is the info bit name of metal number? ZMMNO, right? So, the attribute table naming would be like this. Slash BI is fixed bus. Okay. See if it is a custom object. Custom object means what? Object what we create. Standard object is something which is ready-made delivered by SAP. Or you get zero. Okay. Slash. Then P indicating attribute table. Then the name of the info bit. Now tell me if the name of the info bit is this, what should be the name of the table bus? It will be what? Slash BIC slash P and the name of the ZMMNO. Ah, pair through all the table automatically. Now look at this. Slash BAC slash P ZMMNO. P table, attribute table created. Now logically, I can double click to see the definition. You know, what should be the columns in the table? Our table in any column. If you understood the schema perfectly, you should be able to tell me how many columns will have in the table. Tell me. There will be one column for metal number, metal type, metal group, calde, price, currency. So totally 6, right? Yeah, price. Oh no, price. Currency. Oh no, attribute jod. Like, 1, 2, 3, 4, currency to put 5. This 5 and the key field is this. So totally 6. Correct. But there will be two more fields extra. We'll discuss on that later. Don't worry now. Double it. Don't worry on these two columns. Now what is the key? Look at the key checkbox indicates, so it's a primary key. What is the primary key here? Metal number and all the non-key columns, metal type, group, currency, price and calde. And how are these columns being defined here with the help of what? Data elements. Every info will have the data element. The data element of that object is used here in formulating the table for us. This is the concept. But the tables is blank yet. I have not maintained data manually. I have not extracted from source and loaded. I just created manipulated my table like this. Clear? Now, let me just make one record, okay? How can we enter data manually? Right click on the metal number and say what? Maintain. But in the real time production, you never maintain data like this. It will be always extracting from some source and loading into the master bus. And then say execute. Okay, record is maintained. Say M-101 type is. So I'll say sports. But if you give lowercase, will it accept? Because I never enabled checkbox lowercase, so it will convert the group. I want it as 10. Currency, I want it as INR. Let's say it is 25 rupees. Then the date says 01/01/2015. See, for me, I am seeing it as dd.mm.y. But internally, it will be yyymmdd without dot, without slash. SAP always stores the date format like that. Yeah. Say okay. It is a record version. Now, if I say save, will it formulate one record in the table, attribute table? Now, can I observe the entry in the table? How to do this? Module text step, P table, metal number, go in. I can see the contents of the table here, like this. Look at this. Click on the button, contents, execute this. Now, do I see an entry here? M101, sports, 10, INR, do you see that entry? I can see with a different view also. Grid, you can change settings. User parameters, I want it as grid, so that it will be more easier for you. You get to select grid like thing. So, do you get to see the table data in the entry? Now, when I have maintained certain entry in the master data, there should be something system doing in the backend.
It's really
a dummy. Dummy, not dummy, sir. It is doing something. When I enter some master data, internally there should be something backend happening. SID. So, I should see an SID in where? SID table of metal or product or metal type or which one? Metal, because SID is specific to the key column, not the attribute. So, when I go to metal number and when I go to the SID table and see the contents, how many SIDs I should have? One. M101, SID is 2. Don't worry on the blank record. I'll discuss why later all this. So, 2. M101, SID is 2. Now, the question is, where is this 2 coming from? In Excel, when I was showing, I was just putting some number, okay, 2-bit number. Is this 2-bit number? From where is this 2 coming from? I want to see. Look at this. What it does is, for every info bit, okay, for every info bit, it just says, now got metal number. It will have its own number range, say from 1 to 20 crores, you know, number range. From this number range, it will be generating one SID. Let's say I've got another info bit. Again, that will have its own number range. Every info bit will have its own number range. From this number range, it keeps generating the next sequence number. Now, let's say, now, same in my metal number should have the number range object. Yeah, where is it? Extras menu, number range object for what? What is this? For SIDs. Now it shows me the number range is from 1 to some 20 crores or something. What is the status now present? 2. So what will be next number? 3. Mana database lo sequence concept 2+1, 3 atla or something. And every info bit will have its own range. It doesn't mean that same range is not used for everything. Until now, for example, if this gets 2. Can customer also get 2? Yes. It dan own range. Every info bit will have its own range.
Customization.
So next question is, how do I customize this? Let's say I want to change my, suppose in real time you might go and reach the end of this number range. How do I increase it? Okay. How do I do this? Then we use some T code called SNRO for it. The T code SNRO, how you basically change the number range of it of this. Now how do you change? Look at this. The shortcut of finding out is, I don't know what is the number range object for it, but I know one thing. The number range object will have my info bit name in its description. So to catch that, what I am trying to do, put ZZZZ in everything and last you put star, okay? And then say search algorithms. And then in the description, give your info bit name, star, caps, what is ZMMNO. And then now you remove Z now again. To get that screen, I need to put Z, otherwise it doesn't bring that screen. I know only one thing, I don't know the object name, but only has my info bit name in its description. That's my object name. Just go in. So now it finds you. BIM00019. That's my SID number range object. Catch this old display. You can hold this. So I want to see ranges. You want to change, right? You want to change intervals from 1 to 20 crores. Let's say you want to make it as 100. At a March 1, but Nikos. Okay, next. I can also change my status. Say I want to change status to now 5. If I change my status like this and do, if I refresh my screen and then go into my display, extras menu, number range object for SIDs. Now I should see 1 to what? 100. What is status here? 5. Now when I create a new record now, when I go to metal number, right click and say maintain master data and then say execute and then say create record. M102, I don't know other attributes, don't worry. Will it still generate SID?
Yes.
asset is specific to the key field, yeah, not that. So now what will be asset now which is coming up internally in the backend? Contents F8. Now what is it? 6. I change the status to 5. That you can still alter the number, but general real time dhanam muttukune the scene inga antaru data poda 20 crores and epudu allana mass data. Generally mass data is not so much, okay. Okay, but this is how you create attribute table first. Now I want to show how do you create text table. Now if I see, now if I do my reporting on this, if I execute my report on this, now does it show report group as 10 in the reporting? If I do reporting, if I just show the same data as it is, my business would get to see group as what, 10. But under 10 and 10 then none of the actually business would not give you none of what is 10 under. So they don't understand really what 10 is. Right? They would expect to see some descriptions. Can I use description concept to show what 10 indicates? So in the reporting, what I can do, instead of showing 10, I say show description from text table. In that, if I need to do that, do I need to maintain text table for metal group? Then how do I do this now? I'll go to what? Metal group. How do you maintain text table first? Go to market text tab. Change mode. If you select this, it means you want attribute. But I don't want attribute table for group. I only want what? Text. Now when you say text, when you say with text, you don't have to use any infobics. You just have to say you want to have short description or medium or long. Short is of length 20, medium is of length 40, long is of length 60. Okay. And I'll say when you say long, then the option is long. Now since in the new 7.3 we have infobit of length 250, you want to have extra large, then what you can do? I can say long text. Of length 250 brings. So I want medium, I want medium, long, short, then there's what is the checkbox here? Language dependent. What does it mean? Do you want metadata description of this group in different languages? Yes, it will bring language column in the text table. If I deselect this, it does not bring language column in the text table. Let's have enabled it. That's why when I activate it, does create the text table in the backend. And for the text table, the naming will be T. For attribute table, it is P. And for text table, it is T. Okay. Now when I get into this T, you will see. Metal group, what is year? What is the column? Language. Now both are primary key. Now will it allow saying like 10 English, 10 Germany, 10 German, DE, yes or no? I can maintain description for the same group in multiple languages also. So if I say I don't want that, if I deselect this, then what should be my text table? Warning is okay. What should be my text table now? Do you have language column now? No. So will it allow, now will it allow you to maintain description in multiple languages for the same group? No. Since my metal group alone is a primary key, will it have two records with same 10-10? Will it accept? No. About language government, then I need to get in back and say what? Language dependent and say what? And say, now look at this. This is 1330, extra large text, okay? 120-40. Generally, we can use this when you want to maintain some comments. We'll see that later. Okay, that was fine, yeah? So now what I can do, I can maintain the master data for this group, but all this will be in the real time, will be loading it from the source, but for now, okay, create, I'll say what, 10 indicates what, something say, sports, you wanted to say, cricket, so this medal belongs to category of say cricket, as a bat or ball or something, yeah, 10. So now will it have SI table in medal group or not? Previously it would never have it, now it will have the SI table, because since you are maintaining the mass data of the physical object in the text table, what is the primary key? Medal group. So you are inserting value to the primary key of that column, so will it have SI table? Ippudu vachintundi, I would have shown that before also, but for 10, what is SID was? 10. It is bringing some 10. Why 10? It's a number range. We don't have to worry on that. Clear? Okay, boss? Suppose, now I want to prove that point for you. If I go to Metal Master, I execute. Now, say for this, I am changing this another group with group as, say, I'll put it as 20. Okay, boss? Now, you maintain this 20 in Metal Master. Now in the middle group, will you have SID bus? In the middle group table, will you have SID table for 20, SID for 20? Yes or no? I made it some mass data for metal number. So it will generate SID for the key value, not for the attributes. I have introduced attribute of 20. So metal group SID table lo 20 ki SID vastunda. Will it generate SID for metal group 20? But why it has generated SID for 10? Because I maintain the value 10 in the explicit text table of metal group. That's why it is generating SID. Did you understand this? When I am using text table of metal group, it means I am using physical version of that object. When I am using metal group as an attribute of metal number, it means I am only using structure of that object. Okay, now boss? Uh-huh. Okay, next I want to create some hierarchy, boss. You have made it manually for attribute text, right? Similarly, I want to build hierarchy manually, boss. How do I create? Simple. Just select metal number, right click, say what? Change. Hierarchy, then what do you say? With hierarchies, and say I want standard hierarchy normal. Say we'll have different types of hierarchy, we'll discuss on that later. And say activate once, and say what? Maintain hierarchies, and say create hierarchy z test 001 test hierarchy. Something. Now, if this is the node place where I can start building up my hierarchy. So I'll say text node, something I want to create like this. Sports, okay. That is one node. Under sports, I want to create another text node. Say what? Cricket. Under sports, again, I want one more text node, tennis. Okay, boss. Now, under tennis, I can insert some metal number, say M101. And M102 comes under the simple hierarchy I've just built. You can create hierarchy like this also. Activate. That's it. This is about creating hierarchy. Refresh. Now for metal number, you see a tree structure here. Right click and set display. This will show you hierarchy. You see tree like structure data. That is where we use hierarchies to be built this kind of data. I'm just walking you through. I'll just take up one scenario and then we'll build proper mass data. We'll load it, then see report. Before I go on to scenario, you should know about all this. I can build mass data like this. I can build text. I'm just going through rough, okay? Tomorrow, I'll just go through roughly how to create cube. Then we'll plan up one scenario. Then see how do I do that as a case study. Aptam. Meer okay.